Hi guys, Karen here with another video. Welcome back to our channel. Thank you so much for watching. And today we're going to make a meatball soup. It's a really simple recipe, and I will be using the deep Dutch oven in the color meringue. By the way, this is currently on sale for $200. I got it when it was on sale for $250, so you might want to check that out. It's 5 1/4 quarts, I believe, or 1.5, one of the two. But we're going to make a meatball soup. It's really simple, so you don't need a whole lot of noodles. So these are noodles that I saved from a different recipe. You're going to need some bay leaf. In here, I have chopped up carrot, celery, red bell pepper, some green peppers. They're a little bit warm, but not too warm. But you can use a regular green bell pepper if you like. I have some basil, oregano, and thyme in here. I have garlic, and did I say red onion? I do believe I did. And you're gonna need a few tomatoes, or not, but I am gonna add some tomatoes. A can of tomato paste. And here I am making the meatballs, and I'm going to finish this up and cook them in the oven and then add them to the soup. This is some homemade breadcrumbs. Yeah, sorry. Anyway, this is a really simple and quick recipe and great to use your deep Dutch oven because I want everything to cook. I want the meatballs to be able to go down into the liquid, so that's why I'm not using the soup pot today. Otherwise, I would use it, but today I want the meatballs to go down into the liquid and cook. And I chopped up a lot of this. If I don't use all of it, I just put it aside and use some of it for something else. But you don't have to use this much. Let me stand back. So it is quite a bit, but we like a really chunky soup around here. So let's get into it. So now I'm going to go ahead and put these meatballs in the oven for about 20 minutes. You can use pre-made meatballs if you want to. That'll make the recipe go faster. I'm going to put these in the oven so that they hold together better. I use the Impossible Burger, so I'm just trying to make sure that they cook all the way through. So I'm letting the vegetables cook down and soften because the carrots in there, I'm going to let that soften. And I'm going to add a little bit of water with a seasonal, kind of my own multi-purpose seasoning. It's just like a regular all-purpose seasoning. But I'm going to use that in here and let these cook down until the carrots are soft. This is my all-purpose seasoning. It's just garlic powder, onion powder, salt, pepper, cumin, turmeric, and paprika all mixed together, and I'm just going to add probably a tablespoon to the pot. Now I'll add my bay leaf, and now I'll add the tomatoes. I'm going to add a little bit of water to help this start the process of breaking down faster. There we go. Yeah. This will help it break down a little bit. To this, you can add 4 cups of broth. But I'm going to add 4 cups of water because my vegetables are really seasoned, and it's going to season the water and create its own broth, so to speak. Hope that makes sense. And you just make sure you're taste testing as you go to make sure it is properly seasoned if you're going to use a water that you're seasoning as opposed to your vegetable broth. But or either way, you need to taste as you go, because as I always say, there's nothing worse than unseasoned food. So I'm going to let this cook for at least 5 minutes so those carrots can really soften down. And then I'll show you my next step. To this, I'm going to add a few noodles. To this, go ahead and add your tomato paste. I'm just gonna mix it all in, those noodles and the tomato paste, because it's basically done except for the noodles need to cook and I need to add the meatballs. It's cooking the noodles a little bit, and so I'm going to add the meatballs to this now. So now I'm going to add a few of the meatballs, just a few at a time. And I'll show you guys what this looks like. I'll show you guys what the final product looks like. Okay guys, so this is the final product. It smells so good in here, you guys. It's a nice recipe after a couple of weeks of heavy-duty cooking. I used the deep Dutch oven because I needed the meatballs to go down into the liquid. And this pot works really well for that. If you have a deep Dutch oven or the Dutch oven, it'll work really well for this recipe. And this is what it looks like over here. That's a leftover meatball. I left that one for Maya. She likes it like that. But yeah, I hope you get a chance to try the recipe. It's really, really simple. I know it looked like there were 1,000 steps, but really there isn't. I mean, the longest part of this recipe is chopping. So, but yeah, it's a really quick and easy recipe. If you have meatballs on hand, that's going to make the process a little bit more faster. And yeah, so I hope you guys found this helpful. And let me know what you guys are cooking now that the holidays are over and you're moving forward with January keep warm food. I mean, depending on if you're someplace where it's cold. Here it's hit or miss, but that's how it is in North Carolina. It gets cold some days. Today is 65, so but anyway, I thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.